Heroes Like Us is a series intended at sharing comic book characters from various backgrounds and identities. We won't always get everything right, so feel free to make amendments and corrections in the comments. They're always appreciated. What's not appreciated, however, is any form of hate speech or intolerance, so comments of that nature will be immediately deleted and those users blocked from this channel. This is a place of education and celebration. Welcome to IAYTD and welcome to Heroes Like Us, our series where we look at a certain identity and then we look at superheroes and comic book characters that have that identity. Today we're covering the Romani, and this has been requested by a lot of different people, and that's really interesting. And I'm hoping I get this right, because the Romani people is actually kind of a difficult thing to cover, because it's a displaced people, and so it's not as simple as being born in a certain country. It is a culture that people have traveled, and kind of there are Romani living everywhere across the globe. So Romani are not Romanian. Those are two different things. Though some Romanians can be Romani. Okay, so it gets a little confusing. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to cover the heroes that we know of. We're also going to cover kind of where, if we know where they were born. And so they might have a different nationality than they have as a culture. I also want to say that the Romani people tend to be called gypsies, but gypsies can also be a derogatory term if used incorrectly. There are a lot of connotations with the term gypsy. And here's your little free tip for the day. The term gypped is also not cool to say to people. Because when you say you got gypped, meaning something got taken from you or something got stolen from you, that is insinuating that all gypsies, i.e. Romani, are thieves. So please do not use the term gypped. This has been your life lesson. Now let's dive into some heroes that we know are Romani. We're going to start this list with Nightwing, Dick Grayson from DC Comics. Nightwing is half Romani. His parents were traveling in a circus. They kind of came to America. He was performing with them. And then there's been a few different retellings of his quote-unquote origin story. But the most recent one is that a mob boss basically sabotaged the wires. His parents were killed. He was adopted by Batman and became the very first Robin, and eventually grew up and became Nightwing. In addition to his time as Nightwing, he also spent some time undercover as kind of a secret agent, where he just went by Dick Grayson, and he might have even had another alias so people didn't know who he was. But he doesn't have any powers. There's nothing supernatural about him. He is just trained to perfection by multiple different sources. He's an incredibly gifted fighter, a lot of technology and gadgets just like Batman has, but there's nothing extraordinarily superhuman about Nightwing. Up next from Marvel Comics, we've got Margali Szardos. Margali was born in Paris, but she is Romani and she traveled with the Romani people, but kind of Paris is where she was headquartered at. She is a magic user and eventually took on the role of Sorcerer Supreme way before Doctor Strange. She's very old. Why most people might know Margali is that she raised the mutant known as Nightcrawler. When he was abandoned by Mystique, Margali took him in and raised him in this traveling circus. Nightcrawler was also raised along Margali's daughter. So this brings us to Amanda Sefton from Marvel Comics. So she is the daughter of Margali, and she's also very gifted with magic and eventually took on the title Day Tripper. And that is kind of the alias she used when she helped Nightcrawler, she helped the X-Men, she fought evil, things like that. There was even a time that Amanda Sefton took on the title of Magic from Ilyana Rasputin, and she became Magic, and she took over the realm of Limbo and became Sorcerer Supreme of Limbo. So both Amanda Sefton and Margali Szardos are both kind of Sorcerer Supremes in their own right. Up next, we've got two characters that you likely know a lot about, and that is Quicksilver and Scarlet Witch, Pietro and Wanda Maximoff from Marvel Comics. These two were born in Serbia, but they were kind of raised in a Romani family that traveled And their origin has been retconned a couple times now, but eventually they are taken by the High Evolutionary and experimented on and given abilities. So it's unclear at this point if they're even mutants, which is what for a long time we believed they were. This also changes that Magneto is maybe not their father, and it's pretty sure that he's not. So the canon for a long time has been changed on these two, but basically they now have these powers. Quicksilver can travel incredibly fast, and Scarlet Witch can tap into magic and probability, and the scope of her powers is nearly limitless. So check out this video here for the debate of, is Scarlet Witch an Omega level mutant? Because that is the most powerful that really you can kind of be, but is she immune at all? There's a big debate, so if you want to contribute to that, check that out right there. Up next from DC Comics, we've got Madam Xanadu. Nimue in Wudu. Now, Madam Xanadu is incredibly old. She doesn't age the way that we do. And why that is, she is from a time period back with Merlin, King Arthur. And she battled with Merlin. They both had incredible magic abilities. But he defeated her. And he stripped her of all of her powers. So she's been trying to find ways to get her powers back. She fought with Death. And she actually beat him in a game of cards. Meaning that she earned her immortality. So she's immortal, but she doesn't have the magic that she used to have. But she's incredibly knowledgeable about how magic works and how artifacts might work. But she can't inherently tap into anything now. So in today, kind of in the current DC universe, she works with the Suicide Squad. Sometimes she works with the Justice League Dark. She's kind of this consultant when people need help learning about or doing something that's magical. Now, last for this list is Skein from Marvel Comics. Sybil Dvorak. Now, Sybil is the one character on this list that is Romani, but also born in Romania. So this is the time where they kind of both line up. Now, Sybil is a mutant with the ability to control things with her mind, but she finds hard objects difficult to maneuver, so she tends to use cloth and thread and velvet and silk and, you know, things that are easy for her to use. And so she took on the name Gypsy Moth for a time because she could use these to fly and carry her. She is somewhat a villain, usually fighting against teams like the Avengers. Most recently, we've seen her on the Thunderbolts team of villains fighting against the Avengers. And that's kind of, she's a very minor character, but we've seen her in a couple different storylines. So that is it for that list. I think we got most of them, but if you know of other Romani or gypsy characters, let me know in the comments and maybe somewhere down the line we'll do a part two. Hopefully this was interesting. If I got anything wrong, because I know this is complicated, and so if I got anything wrong, tell me in the comments and let's educate each other and educate, you know, people that maybe don't know as much about this. So thanks for watching this Heroes Like Us. Check this out to watch all the other Heroes Like Us videos, and we'll see you next time.